Hey everyone, Corey with Train Like a Girl here. So today I'm going to go over the 5 mistakes busy moms make when it comes to weight loss. But before I do that, I want to ask that if you like this video and the content in it, make sure you give it a thumbs up, like as Parker does. Comment below and make sure you hit that subscribe button below. So this way you get all the latest information about Train Like a Girl, fitness, nutrition, workouts, everything that you need. All right, so let's get down to it. The 5 biggest mistakes busy moms make when it comes to weight loss. Now, we've all made mistakes when it comes to losing weight. I've done them. In fact, I've done all 5 of these. That's why I know. And I'm going to admit I've done them repeatedly sometimes, sadly. I'm learning, right? But I wanted to make this video so that you can identify if you're making the mistakes, and if you are, to try to help you to stop making those mistakes so you can finally hit those fitness or fat loss goals. Number 1, doing the latest fad diet or just dieting altogether. I've said it before and I'll say it again, diets don't work. I don't care what the newest diet is out there, they don't work. Actually, let me reverse that. They do work. All diets work for the amount of time that you're on the diet. But once you stop, or you're on it for too long, you have such a huge calorie deficit, you'll start gaining weight back. Because you can only do diets for a certain amount of time before your body just says, I'm done. Diets also mean a beginning and the end. But what happens after the end? Most of the time, you don't know what to do afterwards. So once you've come to an end, you just start going back to the way you were. Don't diet. Eat whole, nutritious foods. Give yourself some space in the fact that have that glass of wine, have that bowl of ice cream, not all the time, but let yourself enjoy life and enjoy food. All right, number 2, jumping from program to program. In the 10 years that my husband and I owned our facility, Full Throttle Athletics, in Frisco, Texas, I saw people jump from program to program like it was going out of style. I mean, they would go to this poo camp, this Pilates, this yoga. Like, it just, there was no consistency. I don't know if they were looking for the perfect program or if they were just getting bored. It seems like every 2 to 3 times a year, a new, you have to try it workout comes out. It's blasted over social media, all the latest, you know, celebrities are doing it. Everybody needs to do it. Jumping from program to program does not give you the time you need to work on your goals. Goals take time. When people tell you you can reach your goals in 30 days, they're wrong. Now, there are some exceptions to that. If you only have like 5 pounds to lose or something like that, sure, that's not a problem. But I'm talking about long-term goals. Believe it or not, jumping from program to program will bring your goals to a halt and you will not reach them. Stick with the program for at least 3 months, at a minimum. And even that is a little too short. Remember, goals, whether it be fat loss or fitness, take time. And most of them take at least a year to reach. All right, mistake number 3, no consistency. Just like mistake number 2, jumping from program to program that is not consistent. Sure, you might be working out, but you're not consistent at the types of training you're doing. Just like anything else in the whole world, if you're not consistent, you will not reach your goal. The number 1 reason why people are not consistent is because they don't feel like they have the time to work out. That's just not true. And in fact, I have a couple ways and a couple videos that I'll link below that you'll be able to find how to manage your time better and how to get your training in during the day or week. And I'm talking about if you only have 60 minutes to train a week, 60 minutes a week, but I digress. So ways to make sure you're consistent, plan, 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 plan. I say this all the time. I have all my ladies plan where they're gonna train, plan where when they're going to meal prep, plan if you want, plan when you're going to eat. If you need to be that, you know, get that minute. If you need to plan when you eat, do it. We also have to plan for the unplanned, the unexpected. All right, you're planning on training, going to, you know, the gym at 9 o'clock in the morning, and you get a call from the school nurse because your son or daughter needs to be picked up. Well, there goes your training. So you need to plan when in the next, try to get it within the next 24 hours. Are you going to be able to get your training in? If not, look at the rest of the week. Sometimes you may have to skip that workout. That's okay. Try not to make it a habit, but plan for the unexpected and unplanned. Also, have someone keep you accountable. That's one of the reasons why the ladies I work with hire me, is because I keep them accountable. I keep them accountable with their water. I keep them accountable with their nutrition, with their training, how they're feeling just in general, their stress levels. So if you're not looking for a coach, but you want someone to keep you accountable, grab your friend, grab your spouse, grab your significant other, grab a sister, a family member, whoever. Have someone keep you accountable, because there's like this many people in the world that can actually keep themselves accountable when it comes to a lot of stuff, fitness and fat loss included. So find someone that can keep you accountable. All right, number four, giving up too easily, aka not seeing results fast enough. I get it. We live in a world where everything is instant. The other day, my daughter was upset because on her little tablet, a reading game or spelling game or something wasn't loading instantly. She wanted instant gratification. We told her, hey, calm down. It's loading. It's fine. But it wasn't instant. We expect that with our fitness and fat loss goals as well. We want to see those 20 pounds down next week. And if at least half of that isn't gone by the end of the week, we're done. We're upset. It's not working. I've seen it. I've done it. I've had to talk. My husband's had to talk me off the ledge with that. I've had to talk him off the ledge. Okay? So we don't see those instant gratifications, and so we give up way too easily. So instead of looking at the big picture, and this is what I tell all my ladies that I work with, because I get those messages too from my ladies. Well, the scale hasn't moved, or my pants aren't fitting any looser. It's only been like a week. Sometimes I've even said it's only been a month. Okay? So I always say, let's look at smaller pictures, smaller goals or smaller things that are going to lead us to that big, wonderful goal that we're trying to hit. So some of the goals you might be able to be looking at that can help you are you moving every day? I'm not talking about training or doing cardio or going to the gym every day. Are you moving every day? Or do you have a job that you are sedentary? You're sitting down most of the day. Or are you just not, you know, you get, whether you come home from your job or you're, you know, you pick up after the kids come home from school and you guys just chill. Are you moving? You know, go for a walk, go for a bike ride, take the dog for a walk, play outside with your kids, do something. Even if it's not a day that you're supposed to quote unquote work out or train. Increase that water intake. That is the first thing I work with my ladies. I ask them, how much water do you usually drink during the day? When they first come on with me, how much water? And some of them have gone to, oh, I don't drink water. I don't like water. Or I have my coffee, tea. Well, that's not considered water. To the point where they're already drinking a gallon of water, if not more, a day. So we work on that. Increasing your water, you will see huge improvements, not only in the way you look, but the way you feel. I'm going to put a little side note here. In the beginning, when you start increasing your water, do it slowly. Because I always tell my girls, I want you to get up to a gallon a day, but you will be in that bathroom a lot more. Okay. But that's okay. Just do it slowly. You'll be fine. Mistake number five, overtraining. I see it time and time again. And unfortunately, I'm seeing it more on social media. is people think they need to drive themselves, or as a personal trainer, coach, whatever, they need to drive their clients into the ground, make them feel like they're dying to get a great workout in. No, no. That is so wrong. So I want you to think of it this way. Think of your body as a car, okay? And if you got into your car and instead of, you know, slowly driving, you know, putting the gas pedal down and getting up to speed wherever you're going, if you decided that as soon as you got in the car, you were gonna hit that gas pedal and you went 100 miles an hour every single time you got in that car, what would happen to the car? Now, I don't know much about cars. Okay, I'm actually taking this little example from my husband. He's been using it for years. So I'm stealing it from him. And I point this way because his office is this way. but anyways, so if you got in the car, every time you got in the car, you made your car go 100 miles an hour, no matter where you were going, no matter for however long you were going, what would happen to the car? That car would break down. That car would break down fast. Same thing with your body. If you try to make your body go 100 miles an hour every single time you train, your body's going to break down. You're going to get sick. You're going to get injured somehow. I've seen people's bodies just kind of give up on them, where they couldn't get out of bed for a couple days. And it took a long time to get back into the training. So what do? At first, especially if you're just new getting into training, take it slow. Okay? You don't need to go all out. Do a lot more low intensity cardio. I know it can be boring, but that is what works. I'm not saying the high intensity stuff doesn't work. It does when properly placed in the program at certain parts. It works, but you need to put it in certain areas of the program. Of course, that's when you need to have a great coach. But in all seriousness, even if you don't have a coach or a trainer or someone watching over you, don't go all out every single session, especially if you are just new to training. All right, so those are the 5 mistakes busy moms make when it comes to weight loss. So how many have you done? I know I've done all of them. I've done them all repeatedly. Some of them all together, some of them just one. But I know I've done them, and I know others have. So if you have made those mistakes in the past, how have you fixed them? Or have you fixed them? If not, try doing some of the things that I suggested, okay? Adding more water so that you don't, you know, as a daily goal to hit your big goal. Not overtraining as much, not wanting that instant gratification, not jumping from diet to diet, not jumping from program to program. Okay, so I hope this helps, even just a little. Again, I would love to know how you're doing. If you've made any of the mistakes, make sure you comment below. Give this video a thumbs up if you like the content. Also, please don't forget to subscribe so that you get all the latest information on fat loss, fitness, and nutrition and workouts. All right, have a great day. Bye.